Ever wondering how to edit multiple spatial videos together shot on an iPhone or a Vision Pro so they can play back perfectly on Apple Vision Pro? Or how to reframe a 3D VR 180 video shot on a Canon or the upcoming Blackmagic Ursa Cine Immersive Camera into stunning spatial video for sharing? Usually, the solution requires knowing command line codes in the Mac terminal. But not everyone is a developer or coder. That is why today, I'm excited to introduce you to a free standalone tool with a user-friendly graphical interface. This tool lets you inject Apple Spatial Video Metadata into any video format, flat 3D, VR 180, or even 3D 360. Whether you want to convert your old 3D movie collection for Apple Vision Pro, or edit your own spatial video for better storytelling, this tool is your best friend. Plus, I will show you how to integrate into DaVinci Resolve Delivery page for a seamless professional workflow. Ready to master the art of spatial video editing without the hassle? Let's dive right in. Hi, it's your boy Hugh here, back for another Apple Vision Pro spatial video tutorial. Thanks to the joint effort between Mike Swanson and Andrew Hazelton, we now have a standalone open source tool to turn any 3D video into Apple MV-HEVC format for distribution on Apple Vision Pro, or even on the MetaQuest 3 after firmware V68. You can use any editing software, Final Cut, Adobe Premiere, DaVinci Resolve, or even CapCut to edit spatial video shot on the iPhone, Vision Pro, or the upcoming Canon spatial lens. And use this tool to turn your final render back into correct spatial video. Head over to this link on GitHub and download the latest Spatial Metadata GUI. Then unzip it on your Mac. Open readme.txt. Here is an instruction on how to install all the necessary components. Hit Command and Spacebar together to bring up search, search for terminal and open it. You only need to do this once and never need to see the terminal again. So please bear with me. Copy the first line here, paste it onto your terminal and hit enter. This line installs Brew Package Manager on your Mac. Then copy the second line and paste it onto your terminal and hit enter. This line installs Spatial from Mike Swanson, which is the secret sauce for all things spatial video. The installation is done. Now is the fun time. Right click on the Spatial Metadata GUI and select open. Just hit open here. It is safe. Mac freaked out on open source software. This is 100% free software and 100% safe. Your boy here helped make this. And all of us work extra hard to help grow the spatial video and Apple Vision Pro community. Please give the developers Andrew Hazelton and Mike Swanson a big thank you. And give Kimchi a like. After it opened, right-click on the dock icon, option, keep in dock. Now, next time, you can just drop a 3D video directly on top of the icon. And if you open the Spatial Metadata GUI with the video loaded, you can play it to make sure that it's the video you need to convert onto Vision Pro. The software supports VR 180, 3D 360, flat, which is 3D video from 3D movie or video edited from your iPhone, or even fisheye. Format usually is side by side for 3D video or VR 180. Top and bottom is usually for VR 360 content shot on the install 360 Titan or the Pro 2. If you shot on an iPhone 15 Pro, your primary eye is the right eye for the high quality lens. Canon or other professional camera, it does not matter. For VR 180, your field of view is 180, 360 is 360. For Canon R7 with the new dual fisheye lens, it's actually 144 degrees here. For iPhone spatial video, it is 63.4. We will have a preset for you soon based on camera, so no worry. Just remember flat spatial video is about 60 degrees. IPD or inter-axial lens separation should keep it as a default. For Canon dual fisheye lens content, I use 60 instead of 64, but the rest should be 64 to 65. Horizontal disparity adjustment, you should not touch it unless you know what you are doing to mess with stereo 3D. Uncheck auto bitrate, you can manually set a constant bitrate for high quality delivery. If you are not sure, just use auto bitrate and let Apple decide for you. Usually, it's pretty good and accurate. Now hit encode video, you will be able to see the progress number in the console window. That's it, very easy. The final video can be airdropped onto Vision Pro or uploaded onto an iCloud drive. Your default Apple Vision Pro player should be able to play back spatial video, or you can use Candle XR or Spatial Jam to play back immersive 1080 video. They are both free player on App Store designed for immersive content. What if you have a library of 3D videos and want to bench process them all at once? Now, let's learn how to call this free tool within the free DaVinci Resolve and do batch processing that leverage your Metal GPU power. Download the free DaVinci Resolve Reactor and Cutterverse package. If you don't know how, follow this tutorial right here. Under Cutter link, make sure you have Media Command and Spatial Media checked. Go to Workspace, Scripts, Cutterverse, Cutter link, Media Command. In here, you can source only your video to be processed using this drop down here. Select all the videos. Under Command Script, select Spatial Media LUA file. Click Go. The same tool you just learned will show up. From here, you can batch process all the video. Very easy. Bonus tip for editors using DaVinci Resolve for spatial video editing. Resolve 19 now natively supports spatial video shot on the iPhone 15 Pro or Pro Max. The video will have this 3D icon. You can follow this tutorial right here to learn how to edit spatial video. Here, we have an edited VR180 video from the Canon R5C or R7. Use an adjustment layer to convert it into spatial video format. If you look at the timeline settings, we have 3840 by 1080, which is the iPhone spatial video specs. We set stretch frame to all corners. That is why you see this weird stretching VR180 video here. If you turn off the adjustment layer, inside the adjustment layer, we just have a KVR viewer to reframe my 8K VR180 into 16:9 spatial video. Again, check out this in-depth tutorial right here to learn about KVR viewer. Then in deliver tab, we use QuickTime H.265 timeline resolution. Turn on trigger script, select end of render job, and select the script spatial metadata. This way, if you render your final video in HEVC, using a trigger script to turn your HEVC into Apple MV-HEVC. So the final video is ready to go on Apple Vision Pro without you doing any extra step, like magic. Thank you so much for watching another in-depth tutorial on immersive video production. Kimchi and I are working extra hard to help you create stunning spatial videos, one tutorial at a time. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you never miss an update. If you're interested in learning how to actually edit spatial video, check out our next tutorial right here. If you need extra help, please leave a comment down below. Kimchi will be answering all the comments before he can eat.
That is animal cruelty, Hugh.
See you next time.